Hello students, in previous class we discussed about the table of short run cost. So simple, so this is the explain the short run cost, how we can calculate the short run cost. You can observe that, so in the shapes of TC, TVC, AVC, AC, TFC, so TFC completely like remain constant. So here you can observe that when the ABC decreasing, when the ABC decreasing, marginal cost also decreasing less than this. Okay, when the ABC decreasing, marginal cost also decreasing less than this. See, this is 10 is average variable cost, average variable cost, right? So here when the average variable cost is decreasing less than that, marginal cost also decreasing. When the average variable cost starts increasing more than this, marginal cost also increasing. You can observe that. So always the SMC curve cuts the average curve at the point of minimum from the below, right? So here you have to understand, when the average variable cost curve is decreased, marginal cost also decreases. When the average variable cost decreases less than that, marginal cost decreases. Well, after the certain level of point, after the reach of certain level, after that, see, so after this, when the average variable cost starts increasing more than this, it is also increasing. Okay. And also, when the output is increasing, when the output that is increasing, average cost also, what's happening here? Decreasing. Average cost is decreasing. When the output increasing, average cost is decreasing. Okay, this is the explanation about the table. So this is the short run cost. Once again, I will write the formulas of all these. Okay, see clearly. Formula TFC is equal to TC minus TVC. TVC equals TC minus TFC. TC equals TFC plus TVC. AFC equals TFC divided by 2. ABC equals TVC divided by 2. Okay. AC equals TC divided by Q, or AFC plus ABC. Then MC, TC N minus TC N minus. Okay, these are formulas to understand or to calculate the TFC, TVC, TC, AFC, ABC, AC and MC. Okay, up to this short run cost. Next, we have to discuss another important topic is long run costs. Up to the marginal cost, that is short run cost. Now we have to discuss about the long run cost. Okay, in the long run, you know that very well, there is no fixed factor. In the long run, there is no fixed factor. All the factors are variable. That means there is no fixed cost. There is no fixed cost. Long run costs. Okay. So in the long run, there is no fixed cost. Completely all the cost is variable cost only. Because there is a lot of time. The producer has a sufficient time to change all the factors of production, including land. Land is a fixed factor in the short run, but in the long run, land also consider as a variable factor. There is no fixed factor in the long run. In the long run, we can see all the variable costs. There is no fixed cost. There is no fixed cost completely. It is variable cost. In the long run, we can see two types of cost. One is long run average cost. Another one is long run marginal cost. Fair. LAC, LMC. In the long run, there is no fixed factor. Everything completely variable factors. That's why there is no fixed cost, yearly variable cost. Okay, one is long run average cost, another one is long run marginal cost. Okay, so this is as usual, you know that average cost, it is a cost of total production. Average cost, it's a cost of total production. And marginal cost, that is the cost of extra production of extra unit of a commodity. It is the cost of production of an extra unit of a commodity, addition to the total cost. Okay, so this one we can explain with the help of a diagram, because we have to observe the long run average cost and long run marginal cost. We have to observe the shapes, what will happen. Already we discussed in the short run classes. Okay, this is the shape of long run cost curve. You have to understand, we are discussing about long run cost curve. In that, we can see long run marginal cost curve, another one is long run average cost curve. Average cost, nothing but it's a cost of total production. Cost of total production. And marginal cost is nothing but it is the cost of production of an extra unit of a commodity. It is the cost of production of an extra unit of a commodity. Otherwise, it is the addition to the total cost. The cost is addition to the total cost. Okay, so here you can observe that when the long run marginal cost curve increases, when the long run average cost curve increases, even long run marginal curve also increases. See, when it is starts fall, less than that it is also false. Okay, when the reach up to the certain level of point, after that average cost curve starts increasing. When it starts increasing, even marginal cost also increasing more than this. As long as per the law of returns to scale, IRS, increasing returns to scale, increasing returns to scale, according to that, we can increase the output. How much? That is according to IRS. If we increase the all inputs, land, labor, capital, or organization, when we are increasing all the inputs, certain percentage, like 100%, according to the IRS, increasing returns to scale. So that time we can get more than this. That is, more than this means 200. The input is 100%, output is 200%. Right, that is increasing returns to scale. As long as when we are increasing the percentage of inputs or proportion of inputs, that time definitely we can get more and more proportion of output. That is because of increasing returns to scale. Same here also, so we can observe that as long as in the long run we can get more percentage, more production, percentage of production or more production. So that is when we are increasing the number of units produced, that including the inputs also increasing. Otherwise, when we are increasing the inputs, when we are increasing the inputs, even output also increasing more than the percentage of inputs, more than the percentage of inputs, as like as according to law of which one, constant, like diminishing returns to scale, DRS, diminishing returns to scale. So that is explains the average cost must be rising. Average cost is the must be, you can observe in the table, average cost must be rising as the firm increases the output. Average cost is increasing as the firm's output is increasing. When the firm's output increasing, that time average cost also increasing, you can observe in the table. As long as according to the which one, diminishing returns to scale, in this according to the average cost must be rising as the firm increases the output. Okay, that time when the average cost increasing, that time last to the which one, producer. Then constant, that is average cost remaining constant, no changes along with the output. Along with the output, if the output increase, average cost also increases. If the output is zero, average cost also zero. So that is SMC, like SAVC, long short, like LAVC, long run and long run average cost and long run marginal cost. You have to understand here, when the average cost increases more than this, long run marginal cost also increases. Always the long run marginal cost curve cuts the long run average cost curve at the point of minimum, at the point of minimum from the below. Okay, long run marginal cost curve always cuts the long run average cost curve. Long run marginal cost curve always cuts the long run average cost curve at the point of minimum from the below. From the below. Okay, this is the explanation of shape of long run cost curves. Okay, up to this third chapter, production and cost. Okay, in next class I will give the notes. If you have any doubt about this chapter, about any topic, you can ask. Thank you.